Nathan Ford. Nathan was born in California and grew up in Lake Tahoe, Nevada. He attended college for 3 years before financial problems forced him to drop out. But he spent the last 15 years as an entrepreneur, and he and his wife owned two businesses. They moved to Roswell in 2011 and had two daughters. Nathan Ford, your statement.
I just want to thank everybody for coming, and thank the Roswell Women's Club as well for putting this on. And I also want to apologize to everybody for being late. My flight was 2.5 hours delayed, otherwise I promise I would have been here on time. But just to introduce myself a little bit more, I'm a millennial. And a lot of times when I listen to these Roswell City Council meetings and when I listen to a lot of people talk, what I hear is how they talk about how they want to preserve Roswell for the future. They want to preserve Roswell for their kids and grandkids. I can be some of your guys' grandkids, just so you guys know. But they want to do it at the price of indebting their kids and grandkids. They want to take out bonds for senior pools, and they want to take out bonds for artificial turf. All those are things that people in my generation are going to have to pay for. Not necessarily the people that are voting for this stuff, not necessarily the people that live here now, but it's the future generations that are going to have to pay for it. And I'm not necessarily opposed to these, what I call vanity projects, these wants that we have in the city. What I prefer we do instead, though, is focus on our needs first. We need to put our wants aside, and we need to focus on needs. And the biggest need right now that we need to focus on is we need to focus on and deal with traffic. We have the Holcomb Ridge exit, which is abysmal. We need to deal with it. Obviously, the state foiled, so to speak, what we were trying to do. But that's not the only area that has problems. And I know a lot of times people are talking about how the issue is, well, it's not us driving on these roads. It's all these people that are coming through that are going to use us as cut-throughs and all those things. But I still drive on those roads, and regardless as to whether or not other people are going to use them, I still have to use them, and you still have to use them, and we all have to sit in that traffic. And that traffic wastes time, it wastes money, it's bad for the environment, it adds additional pollution, and that needs to be addressed first. We need to put these parks on hold. We have 900 acres, as was just pointed out. We don't need another 25 acres. What we need to do is we need to fix the roads, we need to address the transportation issues, and once we fix that, then we can start talking about some of these other things. But until that happens, we need to focus on our wants, and not our needs and not our wants. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm invested in this city. And when I say I'm invested in this city, I don't just mean I own a house here. I own two businesses here. My wife and I each own one. Located in Roswell. I employ 8 people right here in Roswell, 5 of which actually live here. So when I'm talking about the taxes that go to GM, that's money that I don't get to invest in my own business. That's money that local business owners don't get to invest in their own businesses. That money comes from somewhere, and it's taken from the local business owners, and it's given, and the residents too, thank you for your comments, but it's given to other businesses, incentivizing them to come here. But my established business that's been here, that's employing people here, doesn't get that. Maybe if I moved it to the other side of Roswell, I might get a little special incentive because that's an incentive area, but that's not good for my business. I'm invested in this city above and beyond a lot of the people on this stage because I want to see this city grow, and I want to see it grow not just in population, but I want to see the businesses in this area grow, and I want to see them thrive as well.